Everything in the heavens and earth fit in one of two categories. The first category consists of things that were created. The second category consists of things that were not created. In the first category, we can place things like the sun, the moon, and even the earth. Also in the created category are things like plants, animals, birds, fish, and man. When we look at the book of Genesis, it says that God created all of these things. But then, interestingly enough, when we look at the book of John, it says all things were made through Jesus. In fact, as if to put an exclamation point on this, John goes on to say, without him was not anything made that was made. In other words, everything in the made category was made by Jesus. This is what the Bible says, and John makes it doubly clear we do not misunderstand his point here. Everything, and I mean everything in the created category, was made by Jesus. So what fits in the non-created category? One thing Jehovah's Witnesses and Christ followers will agree on is that God belongs in the not created category because He is the creator of all things. Isaiah tells us of Jehovah, "Thus says the Lord your Redeemer, who formed you in the womb. I am the Lord who made all things, who alone stretched out the heavens, who spread out the earth by myself." Oh, wait. Does this say Jehovah created everything by himself without any help? That's very odd. Why does the Bible say Jesus created all things and there was nothing that was created that was not created by him? But then Isaiah says Jehovah created all things without any help. This is very odd. I guess we'll have to table that one for now. The question at hand is, what category does Jesus belong in? Does he belong in the created category with the sun, moon, animals, and fish? Or does he belong in the not created category with God? When we ask a Jehovah's Witness, was there anything Jesus did not create? The Jehovah's Witness will say, no. When we ask them, was Jesus created? The Jehovah's Witness will say, yes. But then we must rightfully ask, if the Bible says Jesus created everything without a single exception, was Jesus made by Jesus? Obviously, he could not have brought himself into existence, so we have to assume Jesus fits in the not created category. Dismissing this obvious conclusion, Jehovah's Witnesses will insist, the Bible itself says Jesus was created. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son." Here's where Jehovah's Witnesses will try to confuse begotten with created. But notice the Bible never says created son, it says begotten son. The great scholar C.S. Lewis explains this in a very simple but profound way. He says, "A bird creates a nest, a beaver creates a dam, a man creates a house, God creates a man. A bird begets a bird. A beaver begets a beaver. A man begets a man. God begets God." So back to our question, why does the Bible say Jesus created all things and there was nothing that was created that was not created by him? And then Isaiah says that Jehovah created all things without any help. For a Jehovah's Witness, this is a contradiction that has no solution. But for a Trinitarian, this is explained very simply. Did Jesus create everything? Yes. Did Jehovah create everything without any help? Yes.